So now we got Shaki starting to build his Zulu kingdom, right? Now, Shaka is going to expand his tribe through various ways, right? Through diplomacy, you know, through negotiation, you know, pushing people out completely, right? Various ways. But most of it's done is through warfare and fear, intimidation, right? One of the first tribes he's going to incorporate is going to be his mother's old tribe. You know, the tribe that used to treat him like shit when he was a kid. The ones that used to throw shit at him, rocks at him. And anyway, once he caught those motherfuckers after he incorporated them, like I said, they're going to be the first tribe for him to pretty much take over, or at least one of the first. He's going to impel those motherfuckers. Like, oh, you want to throw shit at me? I'm going to fucking stick this fucking stick up your ass. And maybe I'll stick some shit down your throat too first. Anyway, so that's what happened to those fucking kids. Shaka didn't forget. All right, so anyway. But like I said, most of his work's going to get done through war. And the reason that made Shaka so fucking awesome was he introduced a lot of changes to at least warfare in this part of Africa, in southern Africa. All right? Kind of traditionally, how the way war was fought, there's a lot of ceremonial stuff kind of back and forth, and the armies would stand apart from each other, pretty far apart, and throw spears, right? And people would get hit, people would die, people would get injured, but they didn't do much up close fighting, right? Now these guys aren't Zulus. I just like the picture because these dudes got fucking dick sticks on. And I tripped out on that. So anyway, but yeah, traditional fighting in this area was just throwing spears back and forth across, you know, great distances. And what Shaka decided was, fuck that. I mean, we'll still throw that shit. But after we throw our spear, we're going to run up and fucking stab your ass. And I'm going to have a fucking bigger fucking spear. Right? He's going to introduce this thing called a ikwa. All right? And here's an image of him holding one right here. This is a lot better than a tiny spearhead. Now, the aim of this was to stab the shit out of your ass, especially probably around the rib area. And it worked really fucking well. Now, another thing he did was he enlarged the shield that they used by the Zulus. Here was kind of a more traditional shield. Shaka's going to expand it, make it more the size of a man, about 6 foot long. Cover you from fucking head to toe. All right? So, like I said, he's changing the way they fight. First, it's the weapons and the shield, and then it's strategy. He introduces this thing called the bullhorn or the beast horn. It's fighting strategy. The way it worked was, as his army approached the enemy army, in the front, in the middle, in the front of his army, were his older, more experienced warriors, and that's who engaged the other army. While those two were engaged, his younger soldiers who were on the outside would run around and encircle the army. And then in the back of his army, he had reserves just in case they were attacked from behind. This worked really fucking well. As you can tell down here in the bottom, once they got you encircled, you were fucked. And they just fucking smash you. All right. You're done. All right, so anyway, another thing he did was, according to legend, was they were really fucking quick. And when I mean quick, this army could move. Supposedly anywhere from 50 to 70 miles a day, which is insane. Now, a lot of scholars say this isn't crazy. There's no way it's possible. But supposedly there's accounts where they went 50 to maybe possibly 90 miles in a day. Supposedly barefoot, too. That's some tough-ass feet. All right. Anyway, moving on. There we go. It's from the ball. It's from the ball. It's from the ball.
Smelly green shit, sick my